Hello there everybody and welcome to the show, and today we're at Arundel Castle, the medieval castle in the town of Arundel, West Sussex. So Lorna, why have we come here today?
Well, it's the Tulip Festival, so for 2 weeks of the year, so usually mid-April to beginning of May, the tulips are here and people flock to Arundel Castle to come and see them.
Okay then, well let's go have a look around.
Come on.
This is an interesting piece we've just come across before we got to the tulips. It's a lovely box hedge, Lorna.
I know, we just come around the corner and look at it. I need you to do some of this in my garden. Look, it's amazing, isn't it?
It's a bit like the cloud effect, but it's not quite like that. It's different, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks really good, doesn't it?
I do like it, I really like it.
Yeah, I think it's really different, isn't it? Oh, it looks fabulous.
And it's nice to see it hasn't been gouged out by box caterpillar moth or box blight. So clearly the guys who are looking after this nut they're doing have been spraying it in a timely fashion with Bacillus thuringiensis, no less.
Easy for you to say.
Which, if you can get hold of it, then it's a fantastic organic way of getting rid of your caterpillars. But what a wonderful, wonderful thing. And do you remember, Lorna, when we were at Ramsey Gardens and I told you that we were going to come to Arundel Castle, which we are indeed here, and then I mentioned about the stumperies.
Yes.
Well, there's a big stumpery here, but I just noticed along here is a small stumpery.
A stumparium. A micro stumparium.
A stumpet.
Stumpet?
Not as impressive as the main one, but do you know, but it did catch my eye, so it does have some ornamental value here.
Yeah.
That's pretty. Look how much they've planted in that that grass there over there. It looks so tropical, even at this time of year. It's got a real feeling of the Mediterranean or the tropics. What actually wonderful look to it.
Oh, is that a magnolia there?
What am I looking at? Oh, it is. Do you know what? I think that's the magnolia Delvea. I'll put a little picture of that in flower.
It looks amazing either side of the gates.
Oh yeah, this one's not so good though, is it?
No, that one's not doing so well. But this one, it's amazing.
It's amazing.
It's also tobacco leaf. It's amazing.
It's very big.
Really superb.
Oh,
I love it.
It's great arbor. And what's that growing on that? That's a beech, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
So this is nicely done. You know, we went to Wisley and saw their tropical garden recently, and there really wasn't much happening. It was pretty much a desert of burnt ground. But here we are. We have the tropical garden at Arundel. You've got the cathedral in the background, which is absolutely wonderful. But look at this, it's a riot of colour.
You've got your black grass, you've got your persicaria, and you've got all your bulbs. You know, it's really lush, and that's what you need, isn't it? So they've underplanted this really well. I'm really enjoying this.
So it's mid-April, and it's bright, it's colourful.
It looks really amazing.
Really brings out the feeling of being in the tropics.
Yeah.
So what's that they've got still wrapped up there?
Is it a boutia? Oh, it's a little bit like a boutia.
It does. You've got that arching look on the leaves. Yeah, it could be boutia capitata. See, now they wrapped theirs. They didn't wrap them at Wisley at their peril, because one died like it's dead and a couple severely damaged. But there you go. It's got protection of that Magnolia grandiflora, and they wrapped up a wee bit. So
they're fleeced and gecko taped it up, which is great.
I'm loving this.
I mean, it's quite protected anyway, isn't it? I mean, it is protected here through the walls of the castle. The garden sunk down a little bit, so, you know, got the structure here. But it's lovely, isn't it?
But we're not in a frost pocket because we are on a mound, so we are quite high up.
And we're down on the south coast, so we get, like, you know, the temperatures are warmer down here.
Yeah. But no, I'm impressed. Ligularia, that little purple thing there.
Yeah, that looks
and
lovely.
No slug damage. It looks like to Old Banana stumps.
Yeah.
So it looks like they're applying their slug nematodes to the ground because, yeah. You know, anybody else, and that would be in bits, that would be.
Perfect area,
that's
great, you're
looking
like grass. I'm
making this. Yes, that's the Othiopogon nigrescens, I think.
Yeah.
And I don't know what persicaria that is. But it's a really good colour, isn't
even
it?
Even this is looking lovely, isn't it? Eurypelis.
No, that's gold lace. It's primula gold lace.
Oh, that, I love that.
That's a Victorian form.
I'm liking that. Yeah. Actually, I've got some small terracotta pots, and I've been wondering what to put into them, and now I think I know.
Ah, yeah, it's a good one, yeah.
Yeah.
And see, there's a lesson to you, Wisley, in your tropical borders. So, in the middle of April, and look at that, absolutely fantastic. I'm really enjoying this. I don't need to do a thumbs up, thumbs down for this garden. It's obviously a...
Your voice is going, oh, he's on the
wall. Thumbs up.
I've got your Estelia there,
too. Yeah.
I've got the rocks as well.
See, there you go. So, you've got drama with these rocks when... and the silver of the steel, and it's a steel in really good condition. When you consider we had like minus 7, possibly minus 8 down here, and the steel look brand new, straight out of the nursery.
What's this? It's like, is this a gunner?
Is it rhium?
A rhium, of course it is. Yeah. It's still a rhubarb.
Yeah, rhubarb family, and loads in their growth. Yeah. Or there's a stump
tree
or something there.
Around here, tree ferns coming through.
One of the outstanding features of coming to the garden today is this lawn, an absolute riot of daffodils. Incredible, look at that. That's beautiful. I mean, in fact, it looks like they've made, there are sort of cut lines in there.
They've got a maze through it. And normally it's like a grass maze, and they leave it a little bit longer, but today obviously it's planted. How fabulous is that?
Mm. You can't do the maze though.
No.
Not today. There you go, there's a good view of those water features.
Oh, I can hear one behind me.
Ooh. Oh, it's like a grotto.
I need more T-Rex to come through.
There's Jeff Goldblum when you need him.
Yeah. Can I say?
It does look quite impressive.
Yes. You always say you don't. Is this Martinia? Martini, I think it is. It looks superb, and you always know you don't like them, but I think this just looks...
Well, in this site, this looks absolutely fabulous, but yeah. I wanted to show you this this tree fern.
Ooh,
not covered, and looking really quite good and surprising.
Yeah.
Unlike the one that we saw at Ramsar Gardens, which was absolutely shocking, honestly.
That's good, is it?
No. I might do a... compare of that one.
Yes. With this one.
Going to this one.
Yes.
I mean, it is sheltered. I don't know. I mean, it would have been wrapped up because it still wouldn't look like this if it was. But that's.
I think there's some tree ferns around here as well. You know, you've got them all once. Oh, yeah. Twice a while. So not all of them are good.
It's not even much sign or anything there.
But I'm loving the scorpion.
There you go. It's these rocks. So much. Just tell a story. They give drama. It's really wonderful.
Here we are, glass
houses, Arundel. Yeah. So we've got a lean-to greenhouse.
Very nice.
Ooh, a bit of citrus.
Mmm, citrus lemon.
Scented leaf pelargoniums.
Quite high on the tree,
it's the moon. No, that's just a stick.
Yeah. Ooh, so peaches or nectarines? Nectarines maybe? Well, we're heating here, so obviously we're spending a bit of money heating it up.
Yeah.
Warmer than our house
this winter. Well, do you know what? All the windows are open, so it might just be the sun coming through.
Yeah.
All from the heat.
It
does
feel really
green
and lush, makes you feel like they have heated this up well. We've got the pipes.
Yeah, so are they on?
No, they're not on. But, these have definitely had a bit of heat over the winter.
Oh, yes. No, definitely. Pelargoniums.
Ooh.
Oh, they're starting
the
vines, yeah.
Yeah.
Do you see all the structures that would hold all these vines? I don't know if you can see that very well. So this would have been a massive blanket of vines on the in front of the glass. Big anonium.
What is it?
Bit stretched, yeah.
Yeah, bit stretched, yeah.
Yeah. Interpretation board.
It's also 1853.
That's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's a lovely water feature there, isn't it? It's a bit like a lead, a wellhead kind of thing. But anyway, we've been around the gardens, and I'm going to ask you for your conclusions. Is this a garden that you would come back to?
Absolutely. I want to come back in the summer. It's on our doorstep. I don't know why we don't come here more often. I'm absolutely loving this garden.
It does seem to be one of those gardens that people don't really talk about much. Yeah. You don't hear it in the...
I'd say it's absolutely world-class garden.
Really superb. So you would come back again. Thumbs up, thumbs down.
Two thumbs up.
They've done really, really well, and I'm very impressed by their exotic garden. How good it looks this time of year.
Amazing.
Anyway, thank you for watching. See you in the next video.